Positive rate, you're up.
After the avionics install and test flights back in July, I was finally ready for my L-39 training.
And feel free to bank it right over to 45 if you want.
Okay.
I like a fighter pilot.
This is the first of several videos covering my training.
This fun?
Yeah, I don't have to worry about shock cooling.
Nope.
It's late summer in Rockford, Illinois. I'm in Code 1 Aviation, who maintains jet warbirds and provides initial and recurrent training. Two of the three instructors I had were former Air Force instructor pilots. The instructors were awesome. They really knew what they were doing and they knew how to teach it. My first 2 days of training were with Steve Kirik, a former F-15 pilot. Each day started with a thorough briefing before the flights. Steve didn't waste any time asking the important questions.
Are you prone to any air sickness at all? Have you done much upside down stuff?
Luckily, I had done several aerobatics lessons in preparation for this.
Our mission is to introduce and practice L-39 flight operations for you. So on this first sortie, the big overview is we're going to take off, we're going to go out to the area, you know, ground ops will be longer than normal. Have you taxied it at all?
Yes, I have.
Okay.
We spent a few hours briefing for the first flight, and then Steve went over every switch and every gauge in the cockpit.
Have you seen one, a control lock?
Mine has like a Velcro thing that holds the stick.
Yeah, that's a Code 1 mod, okay. Just to keep it out of Buck's gut.
He's talking about my next instructor, Buck Windham, who you'll meet in the next video. But watch till the end of this video and you'll see the joke backfires. Steve helped me get strapped in for my first flight, and then we went through the engine startup checklist.
All right, you look marvelous.
Throttle is on. It's on cutoff, and the parking brake is set, and now closed canopies.
All right.
So the big thing is, in engine starting, is we always want to keep our hand on the throttle. All right, that's your job, is fuel on, fuel off.
Okay, Sapphire Ready is on, engine start, push for 2 seconds, and then I'm going to start my timer.
Okay.
I get my hand on the throttle. So I'm going to give him a 2, right?
Okay. Yes.
Okay.
So if you see the EGT going past 500, then shut it.
Yes, because a normal jet will peak, you know, 400 to 450 in that range, okay?
Okay.
And if it's going through 450 and still moving, you're getting towards 500, go ahead and shut it down there. Don't play wait and see, because that's not normal.
Okay, and I'm moving throttle now. Okay. Idle.
One thing you're watching for is a hot start. I'm watching these two instruments closely. RPM is on the left, and exhaust gas temperature is on the right.
15 seconds. Okay, we have EGT is good, 56%.
Taxied to runway 1 and did a full engine run-up since it was our first flight of the day. And here's something I didn't know about jet aircraft ground operations.
Airman's information manual says that air traffic control expects a turbine-powered airplane to be ready for departure upon reaching the end of the runway.
Airman 87 Delta, traffic snow factor, proceed on course runway 1, cleared for takeoff.
Cleared on course, cleared for takeoff runway 1, 87 Delta.
Pull on the runway, center the tire, stop the airplane, run it up to full power, lights are out, engine instruments are good, and release brakes, okay?
Engine looks good, let's go. Bit of right aileron, we got a little right to left, there you go. There's 80, there's 90, 95, start the stick back.
The nose will lift off at about 105. I just want the nose tire just off the concrete. So I'm gonna rotate enough, the strut extends, and this tire just comes off the concrete. That's gonna be about 5 or 6 degrees nose high.
Just freeze it right there, let it fly off, that's perfect. Okay, hold that nose, set that 6 degrees, retract the gear.
Gear up.
Lower the nose just a little bit, there you go.
I got 140. Hops up.
After doing steep turns, slow flight, and stalls, we did what Steve calls the nose tracking exercise, or flying the lift curve.
Okay, so what we're going to do is we're just going to go into a hard turn here, 200 knots, going to set 100% power. I'm just going to do a nose tracking exercise. I'm going to start the nose tracking across the horizon. See how it's going faster and faster? Feel the light tickle now. There's the light tickle. There's the moderate. Well, look what happens when we stall it. See the nose track stop?
Yeah.
Then we just want to ease off the light tickle, get it tracking again. That's how you fight an airplane.
We're going to keep slowly adding backstick pressure, and what you're going to see is the nose tracks faster and faster across the horizon. Then we're going to get the light buffet. So we're going to fly right up this lift curve, and then we're going to get the light buffet.
Okay, you have the flight controls.
Okay, I have flight controls.
Okay. I got the power set for you so we can go ahead and roll in to the left.
Okay.
Clear left. Start tracking that nose. Pull a little harder. Light tickle. A little more. There's moderate. A little more.
Okay.
He's off. Get it tracking again. Keep it tracking. Okay. Now come back to moderate. Moderate, there you go. Now heavy buffet. Tracking.
So when you're fighting a guy, if you were doing fighter, that's kind of where you fly the airplane, is in the light buffet the whole time, because you're getting max lift, max turn with minimum airspeed bleed.
Okay, that's what we wanted to see, okay? Pretty cool, huh?
Yeah.
All right, I have the aircraft again.
Your controls.
Then came my first simulated emergency, a hydraulic system failure.
All right. So, right now, after we cleaned up, after your stall series there, you got a hydraulic system light flashing, okay? So you have the aircraft, okay. You have the flight controls.
On the L-39, hydraulics control the landing gear, flaps, brakes, and speed brakes.
When does the hydraulic system malfunction light come on?
When the pressure is below 60.
Yeah, so
bars.
So when the light comes on, it's telling you to do what?
Check your...
Look at the gauges,
yeah,
right?
Pressure.
So when you look over there, what are you expecting to see?
Well, the main should be less than 60.
Yeah, and hopefully you see 150 bars in the emergency, right? If that's the case, emergency over. Not a big deal. I can recover the airplane, right?
Okay, I'm going to check the gauge.
Okay, so the left one reads zero, and the right one reads exactly what you have right now, okay?
Okay. I got about 145 on the emergency.
Okay, so what do you got to do to recover the airplane?
I need to get the gear down, most importantly.
Okay.
And then if I have pressure, flaps, and braking.
Okay.
Well, actually, braking is more important than flaps.
Okay.
So the gear down will be first.
Okay. So go ahead and identify the most inboard red handle with the tire tread on it there.
Okay, I got it.
And you're going to go ahead and pull it aft.
Okay, we're below 180.
Yep.
Here, going back.
We got the gear door open. There's the nose gear first.
Yeah, I see the indicator.
Okay. Left and then the right. So that's a proper indication, right? Three green and a gear door open light.
Okay.
Lower the nose just a little bit so we don't slow down.
Okay, now you can put the landing gear handle up.
Okay, gear going up.
Okay, I have three reds and gear doors are closed.
Okay, and now you can go flaps up at 140.
Like I said, anytime you have a hydraulic problem or a more likely electrical problem, this, as long as you got good emergency hydraulics, it's like pulling a mechanical lever, okay? The gear's going to extend.
So we're going to turn the airplane around, and we're going to do the rat extension, okay?
Okay.
Identify the rat handle.
Okay, I have it identified.
RAT stands for Ram Air Turbine. It's a wind-driven emergency generator in case your main generator fails.
And then, you know, with the RAT out, it says should provide you power through the flare. Our battery is much bigger and better than what theirs were. I'm sure they were, you know, when they were more heavily AC dependent than we are. So I'm sure it was like a true emergency if they got down to the battery. You know, we're talking like 10 to 15 minutes versus us, we would probably fly around for an hour on our battery.
It'll feel a clunk when it comes out, and then a little vibration, then it'll go away.
All right.
Okay, so go ahead, extend it.
Okay.
You feel a little clunk there?
Yeah.
And I'm not hearing the vibration, maybe a little bit. And if you turn your main generator off, the voltage should stay at 28. Go ahead and turn your main generator off.
Okay. It's off and the voltage is still where it was, 28.
Okay, now go ahead and extend the speed brakes. Watch the voltage.
Okay. I did see a change.
Oh, just wait, watch it.
Oh, yeah.
Hopping, right?
A little bit low. That's still holding 25.
Oh, it's still holding it, huh?
Right now, 25.
Okay, so you can go ahead and put the speed brakes back in.
Okay, speed brake forward.
Okay, and then you can turn the main gen on, right, and you can return the RAT handle forward.
Okay, generator's on, RAT handle forward. And it should come up, right?
Yeah, it should just come up, but we don't know for sure. I can feel a little vibration, it's spinning down. Okay, so we're going to do unusual attitudes real quick.
Okay.
We'll do one of each here, clear above us.
So anything more than 20 degrees nose high, what we want to do is we actually want to roll to the horizon, which will automatically start the nose tracking down immediately. Okay, so we're going to increase the bank up to 90 degrees of bank and let the nose slice down. As our nose approaches the horizon, we want to be wings level as our nose gets to the horizon. And we want to check our airspeed right here.
Hey, you have the aircraft recover?
My aircraft.
Where do you want to go? Do you want to go down
power to the
in? Or over to Delta? Proceed on 7, cross runway 1 and 7. And
excellent, excellent. Okay, I have the aircraft. Controls.
Controls.
Get a little speed here.
Nose low recovery. And this is where, like, your instrument ones, where you talk about the graveyard spiral. Like, if we've got bank in and we start pulling back on the yoke, what happens? Or on the stick? Just tightens it, right? Alright? So what do we want to do? First thing we want to do is eliminate the bank and then pull to the nearest horizon, okay? Well, guys are fine with this, but what happens if you're like this?
Hey, you have the aircraft recover? Okay, once the G comes on, the airspeed stops, go ahead and get it back in.
Okay.
Those wings level, there you go. All right, I have the flight controls.
Control.
That's it, let's get some ATIS going. We'll start heading home, okay?
Okay.
Rockford Tower, Experimental Jet 187 Delta is 15 to the west with Mike, or November. Request initial for the overhead, multiple options.
Experimental 187 Delta, Rockford Tower, good afternoon. Enter a 3-mile initial for runway 1.
3-mile initial to 1. 87 Delta.
So if we're at 12,000 feet and we're coming back to 2,300, how much altitude we have to lose? Yeah, 10,000. Make it easy.
Yeah.
All right. So multiply 10 times 2.
20 miles.
20 miles we want to start down.
All right, I'm doing some math here. We are 10 miles away and we have 10,000 feet to lose. Oh no, 7,000 feet.
Okay. Yeah, so it should be about 14 miles, right? So we're a little bit behind.
Okay, so.
Oh, there you go. Just push the nose over. If you need speed brakes, go ahead and use them.
Okay. Use those so we can push down more.
Isn't this fun?
Yeah, I don't have to worry about shock cooling.
Nope. Yeah, don't try this in your Columbia.
So we're just going to, the first one will just come up initial to do the overhead approach. Now that is just the entry into the pattern. So people get confused. They go, oh, request the overhead. The overhead is just your initial entry. So you're entering over the airport at a high speed. You're going into this, what they call the brake turn to help you decelerate and bleed off your speed just to get the downwind speed, which is 180. All right. So because we're in a class Delta and we're civilians, we're going to do 200 knots here. So 90% power gives us 200 knots.
Rockford Tower, 187 Delta, 3 mile initial, 1 to runway 1.
Sir, 187 Delta, roger, left brake at your discretion, advise turn and base.
Clear for left brake, we're going to brake at midfield and we'll advise the base.
That work?
Brake zone, they expect you to brake in the first third of the runway, all right? If they say just clear to left brake or right brake, they expect you to brake in the first third.
If you look off to your left, just past the blue, the light blue hangar down there, is about midfield, okay?
Okay.
There you go.
A little high.
This is just the entry to get into the closed traffic. Once we're, after we come up initial, now we're just normal closed traffic.
Not that big of a correction. A little smaller, there you go. Looking good so far though. Now as you roll out here, you start decreasing your bank angle. You'll have to raise the nose to maintain your altitude.
Okay. Tower, report 5 miles out.
Low 180, here, come out.
This initial leg, all the way through the brake turn to what they call the perch point, is at 1,500 feet. We don't descend, okay, until we leave here. This is our final turn.
Okay, so push the nose down, collect the flaps, roll in, and set 85. Check landing flaps. Okay, 85%. Look at the runway, fly around, the nose down, there you go, that'll keep your 140. Pitch for 140 now with 85%, there you go. And 87 Delta's left base.
87 Delta, roger, check low downwind 34012, runway 1, clear for the option, that's the option, left close traffic, proof.
Now our aim point, do you understand aim point? So out the windshield, if you look right in the middle of the windscreen, that should be like right on the end of the runway or the numbers, okay? And that's a good aim point. So if I roll out on this imaginary 3-degree glide path, okay, here's the end of the runway, that's my 3-degree glide path. Now I can, ideally I intercepted here at a mile at 300 feet above the ground.
So aim point airspeed, put the threshold, nope, you're aiming short, you're aiming way short, there you go. Power just to maintain, aim point airspeed, hold that aim point for now, because we're a little flat, hold that aim point airspeed. Okay, three green, flap speed brakes, and landing clearance. Now keep driving down now, there you go, keep driving down, keep driving down, driving down, smoothly pull the power, there you go, keep flaring, keep flaring, okay, power in, speed brake in, flaps to takeoff.
We did many more touch and goes and then shut down and debriefed the flight. And that was how I started my L-39 training.
You had a hell of a first day.
Just stop forward.
In the next videos, we'll cover high altitude flight, emergency descents, and simulated flameouts, which were tons of fun. So click subscribe if you want to see those. And let me know in the comments what else you want to see about the L-39.
Hey, will you put the bungee strap on?
Yeah. Is it hitting your gut?
No, it's just easier to get in and out.
I was just giving you a hard time.
Ah! Yeah, I know. Getting fat.